Right, guys, today we're going to be doing just a one-on-one sort of a creating space, attacking the hoop itself. So I need one of you defending and one of you attacking. The attacking is going to be on the outside cones over there. Basically, what you're going to do is you're the outside person, you're going to pass it to the defender. The defender is then going to pass it back to you. Once that, then you're going to come out and sort of like jockey and try and shoot into either a space where they can't shoot or where they have to be able to pass the ball off to somebody else. The attacker, when you need to drive up and lead to the hoop, or if there's no space behind or you can't get through, create that space so that you can step back and then take a three or a two. Okay, so all I'm going to do is a quick demonstration with Connor. If you go to the coach, because I know you're a better player than I am. Connor's going to pass the ball in. I'm going to pass the ball out of him, and I'm going to come out of him, because obviously you're not going to stay there for the whole time. I'm going to come out of him. I'm going to either try and show him down this way or back that way. But I'm just going to try and keep myself open so that in case you do drive on me, I can come back and drop him back. Do we guys understand what we're asking for? Hey, do you have any questions? The whole idea was creating space. How would you create space? If I'm trying to put Connor, you'd either step back or try and hit. But how would you, if you were trying to do it, if the defenders, if there's multiple people around you, how would you create that space? Not obviously just walking around, obviously. What sort of skills would you use to create that space?
So first of all, to get open, I'd probably use a V-cut. So I'd take my man toward the basket and then explode up so I can get the ball. So I'm open the first time round. And then I think to get open, I'd probably use a different type of dribble move, or I'd catch the ball without using a dribble and use a jab step to shift my man.
Okay, do you want to just quickly show a V step for me?
Okay, so that would be without the ball first of all. So if I had somebody defending me, so if the man's on me, I'd take my move to the basket and then explode up there.
Connor's showing me that he's showing you the whole creation of that space. So he's gone into that space, exploited the defender, and made them go into a little box. After that, he's explosively done and used his basketball knowledge to explode out to find where the space is so that he can either have more time to either shoot or pass it off and create a better move. On a one-on-one situation, that's a great one, because if you're dribbling and then you create that defenders are going that way, travelling in momentum, they don't have, because you know what you're doing, they don't. When you turn back, they either recognise what you're going to do or know what you're going to do already, as they know what type of player you are, or they get caught off guard. By when you step back, you've got that little bit of space to mean that you can do either a shoot or pass. Okay. How can you improve that? So say if you were driving a lap, how would you improve it? What sort of skills would you want to improve first off if you were attacking, for example? What sort of skills would you want to have if you were trying to do what we just did? So with the V cut, with the step back, what sort of skills would you want?
Well, you definitely need to have a good knowledge of vision, because you need to be aware of each space. So if you don't have a good vision, you're not taking into account who's around you. You won't know whether or not you have the space to make that V-cut. You could be cutting into somebody else's space. So definitely developing your vision across the court is your best skill.
Knowing where everybody else is and seeing about where creating that space, not just you, but instructing or maybe other people, or seeing where, so say you're here and Theo's over there, for example. If you know he's there, going into your space point, because he can do his job there perfectly fine. How else would we improve that, for example, if you were the defender side?
Deny middle, so deny another drive as much as you can, and then just guide them towards the bottom corner where there's less options to make a shot or a layup.
Exactly. If you're in the corner, for example, you've got to come either out to open up the chance, or you've got to shoot from that tight angle. With the middle drive, as you said, it's directly to the hoop. I think you've done a layup, or you can stop it.